When I was a child, I used to lay in bed late at night, staring at the ceiling, listening to my father scream. Scream at my mother, scream at yet another failed masterpiece. Finally, just scream out into the darkness. It became my lullaby. And even when they took me away, the screams followed. I was once told that insanity runs in my family. It's time to make it stop.
Reeks in here.
I swear that dog doesn't shut up. How the hell did you get out? Go on, get out of here before I find a way to keep you in there for good.
I wonder when was the last time this place saw sunlight. What's wrong with this thing? Huh. I don't remember that being there.
I can hear you out there. Please, please help me. It hurts. Oh, it hurts so much. I can't take it anymore.
Yes. Thank you. It's so good to feel that there's still beauty in this world.
I think it is.
Oh, hey there, princess. You want to sit on Daddy's lap? Come on, it's all right.
Hey there. Oh, come on, don't be afraid. It won't bite. Here, try for yourself. No, that's not quite right. Still not quite there. You know what? I have an idea. Go get your crayons.
right, cry! Seems like everyone's solution to everything in this house.
Oh, Princess, don't sneak up on me like that. Especially when I'm working. So, what do you think? Oh, you like it? Well, that makes one of us. Thank you. You have to come out. She's waiting for us. Don't make me do this by myself.
No. I don't want her to see me like this. I'm sorry. I can't.
Supposed to do now? I can't do this without you.
I need you! I need my medicine! Oh, please! Oh, it hurts so much! Why won't you help me? Why are you punishing me like this? Whatever I did, I'm sorry!
Thank you. feel something. I look at you and I see nothing. Not the beautiful girl I fell in love with. Not the mother of my child. Not even the hateful monster you pretend to be. You're just empty. I look at you and I feel nothing. And it scares the hell out of me.
You forgot to say how hideous I am. Go on, I know you want to.
God, not that again.
I know you're disgusted with me, admit it.
You're right, I am disgusted with you. But it has nothing to do with the way you look. I'm disgusted with what you let it do to you. How you let it change you.
What? Oh, that's all right, honey. Something got into Mommy's eye, that's all. You be a good little girl and go to sleep. Daddy's working, so we can't disturb him. Mommy has to go downstairs and take a bath. I love you.
More first and foremost, his muse. Her beauty and talent drove him. After the accident, she became a burden. A disgusting monster screeching out from her bed. An anchor weighing him down. This place is a mess.
I can hear you in there. I'm coming, you furry little bastards. You're not getting away this time. Oh, where'd you put that damn key? To come down here!
Thank you.
What are you doing? Put that down! You're much too old for that childish nonsense! Finally! Are you ready to embrace true art? Creativity is not a toy, it's a gift!
Finally.
Creativity is not a toy, it's a gift! Do you want to squander it like all those careless brats out there? I warned you time and time again! I won't let you waste time in these mindless doodles! This is for your own good! Finally! Are you ready to embrace true art?
Oh, the summer trees. So green and vibrant and full of life, but also young and inexperienced. Let's try to find them a more poignant season, where they are wiser and have some stories to tell.
Brilliant! Let's add some more of the same color. That won't make it boring or predictable. They sway in the breeze, but are none the wiser, just like you! Thank you.
Ah, yes! The autumn of life, when man seeks shelter from the elements. Let's see how our little hut fares when the skies grow dark. No! Put that down! You are doing so well! Which part of dark skies did you not understand? You are doing so well! I warned you time and time again! I won't let you waste time in these mindless doodles! This is for your own good! Finally! Are you ready to embrace true art? Ah, yes! The autumn of life, when man seeks shelter from the elements. Let's see how our little hut fares when the skies grow dark. No, any old house will do in times of prosperity. We need to see how it fares when misery darkens the sky. You see? In the end, all we take for granted is fragile and temporary. Man passes, while nature endures. Speaking of which, I don't think our proud stallion likes the weather. Let's brighten things up a bit. A wet rag won't do us any good, no matter what color it is.
You're not listening! How is some soggy grass going to help here? We need to make it warmer! That's right! The sun bestows its kind rays upon the land. It's getting warmer and warmer until finally... Marvelous, isn't it? I know it seems like a tragedy, but a beautiful tragedy is always better than an unremarkable existence.
In his own way, I believe he meant well. He wanted me to excel, hoping that when the time came, I would succeed where he failed. Avoid his mistakes. God knows he made plenty of those.
All right, young lady. Shall we continue? Right. Whatever happens, just keep looking at me and listen. Now, where was I? Ah, yes. The princess was all alone in the dark.
Princess, keep looking at me. Look at me!
And yet, she felt that the evil witch was lurking nearby. As her eyes adjusted to the darkness, she saw something moving in the corner of her eye. And yet, she did not dare to move. for she knew that that would be the end of her. The princess heard a fearsome growl. The witch had unleashed her familiar, the hellhound. The monster.
Do you want this story to have a happy ending or not?
God damn it! Not again! Fine!
Because the princess wouldn't stop fidgeting, she was set upon by the evil witch's minion and dragged off into the darkness, never to be seen again. The end.
My fault. It was always my fault. All I had to do was stay still, day after day, for hours on end, until he would finally get it right. I've lost count of how many attempts there were, but each one made me feel like I was his greatest failure. After all this time, after all I've been through.
Stay here. Your mother and I need to talk.
This is all you have for me? And of all places, you chose this room.
You think I don't hear that? Stop crying! Don't make me come in there.
So many memories. This one room. Filled with more memories than I can count.
I thought I told you to be quiet!
Oh, the lovely memories. I imagined him standing there, all smug and pleased with himself, thinking this piece of canvas was somehow going to fix everything. I imagined what I would say to him, what I would do. Why, Daddy? You shouldn't have. Really? Shouldn't have!